Oh.
Remember Chuck E. Cheese, the old
Yes.
arcade with the singing animatronics? Of course you do. I just found out they went bankrupt recently.
Really?
In fact, my horrible experience there as a very little kid. I was no older than 8 or 9. It was like my third and last time ever at a Chuck E. Cheese. This specific location closed down years ago, but it used to be basically down the street from our old house. My mom took my little brother and I, and she let us roam free and do our own thing and play the games while she sat at one of the tables reading like most of the other parents. I was playing this clown game where you had to shoot the clown's teeth out with this little cannonball shooter. I was playing the games that would get me the most tickets for the prizes. I finished the game again, and the ticket shot out from the ticket slot. That's when I felt a tap on my shoulder. I turned and jumped in my seat. I was greeted with a giant Chuck E. Cheese mascot in my face. He held out his hand for a high five, and naturally I gave him this high five. He then pointed at the tickets and gave me a thumbs up. I think I just continued laughing and smiling and said, yeah. Then he pointed at the tickets once more and motioned for me to follow him. So I ripped the tickets from the slot and followed the giant mascot. As we walked across the main floor, a couple other kids around like 6 came up to him saying, hey Chucky, and gave him both high fives. I kept following him, wondering if he'd tell the other kids to follow.
No.
He would turn back every few seconds to make sure I was still following. Finally, we made it across the main floor by the stage towards this back area, where he waved me to follow him through this employees-only door. What I remember about how I was feeling, let's just say a combination of weird and excited. We entered this narrow hallway. I felt kind of special for being allowed access back here. Keep in mind, I had the mind and maturity of a very young child. The mascot led me to this back room where he motioned for me to enter first, so I did. It was a small changing room type of room. It had a few lockers on one wall, one long bench extending half the length of the room. That was it. He entered the room and shut the door behind us. I noticed he locked it. That's when I became confused and afraid. I thought he was taking me to get a bunch of free tickets. What could he possibly do in this empty room with me? He approached me, put his furry mascot hand on my shoulder, and then started rubbing from my shoulder to my arm. It seemed as though he tried to reach lower with both of his hands, and I pushed him off and yelled, stop.
Aww.
That's when the person in the suit lifted the mask off his head, revealing some sweaty, middle-aged man underneath. He started to remove the rest of the costume from himself as he told me to be quiet. He sat there watching, shaking, and plotting my way for the door. When I thought he was distracted enough by the suit, I tried to run past him for the door, but he grabbed me and told me to stop.
How rude.
He gave me all the free tickets I wanted if I just behaved. I started to follow him to the door. He tried to cover my mouth, but I think he gave up when he realized it wasn't worth the risk for him.
Ha!
I unlocked the door and ran back down the hall in tears. I ran back to my mom, yelling at her about what just happened. She was distraught. I went to the front desk. The girl at the front desk seemed to be in a panic as well, and I think she called for her supervisor. Pretty soon, all the music was stopped, and the place was put into a lockdown of sorts, where all the kids were to go to their parents. A bunch of workers ran to the back section. Eventually, police showed up outside. I had to give my whole story to a crowd of like 6 people, and I was extremely nervous. The man in the chunky suit was some random creep who snuck into the back section of the building to dress in one of the suits. Apparently lure children to the back. Realizing and looking back at that now as a grown adult is disturbing and disgusting. And I was the victim of a predator. I never found out if that monster was caught.
Aww.
I used to work for Chuck E. Cheese very briefly when I was 21 years old. I was one of the janitors slash maintenance workers. No, not very awe-inspiring. I was broke as hell and needed money. All my job really entailed was cleaning tables and keeping the play areas generally clean. Sounds easy, but there was never really a time to just sit and take a breath. There was always something to clean or take care of. I would also be in charge of turning on and off the animatronics, opening the stage curtains, fixing busted arcade machines and things of that nature. My shifts would always be later, from like 4 to 10 p.m. My location closed at 8 on weekdays and 9 on weekends. I would stay an hour, sometimes 2 hours after, to get the place in top shape, ready for the next day. So this one night, I was working past close like I usually did. Everyone had already left the building, including the other workers, so I was the last one in the building. I was dragging my cleaning cart around the arcade area. I had already turned off all the game machines. I was by that space-themed arcade machine where you had to press the button at the right moment to stop the light on the jackpot bulb. As I was passing by this machine, space-themed music suddenly emits from the machine at a very loud volume. The lights start flashing again.
Ooh.
I fiddled with my keys to access the control port of the machine to turn it off again. I'd never seen anything like that happen before. It suddenly just freaked me out. Only because I was all alone in that big building pretty late at night. The weirdness didn't stop there, though. By this point in the night, I had already shut down the animatronics on the stage.
Mm-hmm.
I heard Chucky's pre-recorded laugh break the silence of the room. Started pounding again.
Oh, I'm not afraid.
It almost sounded glitchy. I ditched my cleaning cart to go backstage and check on the animatronics. I could see they were in their idle modes now, meaning they would move their limbs and heads around every so often. I would have to go to the control room to turn them off. This was the second strange thing to happen that night. I started getting paranoid.
What strange thing? That's weird.
Chunky animatronic was facing me, and its head angled down perfectly to look as though it was looking at me. It's bizarre. Bizarre that I was finding.
Holy shoot!
I'm not crazy, but for my own peace of mind, with my eyes on the chunky animatronic, I walked past it, closer to the control room. I waited there for a few seconds, and the animatronic spun 90 degrees to face me once more, perfectly. I swear it was once again looking right at me. Laughter emitted once again from the animatronic. But in a creepy, glitchy, cut-off manner, this time much louder, obviously because I was right next to it. I ran to the control room to hit the switch to turn everything off on the stage once more. I left the control room, and the Chucky animatronic was still facing the direction it was moments before. I left the stage through the curtain and just felt uneasy. I started to think maybe it was all just getting to my head. That's when I heard the horrible laugh again come to the stage behind the curtains. That was the last straw. I took my card, clocked out, and left.
Aww.
I texted my boss the next day that I had to leave early because I was
yep.
extremely sick.
Poor fella.
That wasn't a problem. But I never mentioned anything about the animatronics being left on. When I asked him if the animatronics had some kind of motion detecting feature to look at people, he said no, it didn't.
Mm-mm.
Not the most superstitious guy. I firmly believe I wasn't the only presence in that building that night. I don't mean there was another person in there.
Mm-hmm.
This is a story from my childhood.
Oh.
I like to look back on too much.
Mm-hmm.
Little sisters and I had a Chuck E. Cheese one evening.
Aww.
My sisters are 4 and 6 years younger than me, so it was more for them.
Mm-hmm.
My mom just wanted me to come along. My mom was playing games with my sisters, so I went to do my own thing. It was my only time ever at Chuck E. Cheese, so I was trying to play every game at least once. Eventually, a worker in a red polo shirt came up to me. He was in his lower to mid-20s, I'd say. He didn't seem that old.
Mm-mm.
He asked me if I wanted some more tokens. I said, yeah, sure. He told me to follow him. He led me through this sketchy back door, which led to a back exit. I asked him where he was leading me. He said to his truck. He told me not to tell anyone, but that he had access to all the tokens he wanted and just kept piles of them in his car.
Odd.
I stopped following when I realized he was leading me to his car.
Mm-hmm.
I told him my mom would be mad. He tried to push that I follow him a little more, but I gave up. Before I walked back inside, he asked for my AIM username, and I gave it to him. I was excited for new friends on AIM. For those of you who
don't not a good choice, dude.
Instant messenger that was all the rage before smartphones and texting really became a thing. don't remember his username. All I know it was something with this name in it, which was Ben. I would sign on to AIM every single night, including that night after Chuck E. Cheese. I signed in, and I had a few friends online. Next thing I knew, I got a message from Ben.
Aww.
I added him to my buddy list. He said, "Hey, it's Ben from earlier." I replied, "What's up?" and we started chatting. He chatted with me as if we were good friends already. I asked him how he was able to get all the tokens he wanted. He said it's easy when you work there. He told me he was going to come to my house that night with a bunch of tokens.
No.
I told him, no, it's okay. He told me, no, it's fine. You live really close to me anyway. I replied, how do you know where I live? He said he followed my mom's van on our way home. I blocked his account.
Whoa.
I was beyond scared. I told my friends about it on AIM. Some of them said I should tell my parents.
Bluffing.
Heard a truck pull up outside through my open window. I looked out the window and saw the black truck that Ben guy was leading me towards earlier. I saw him get out from the truck, and I know he spotted me because he started walking over to my window. I pulled the window in and locked it, and then shut the blind. By that point, he was already halfway to my window. He was waving his arms at me. I ran to my mom to tell her. She didn't find it funny, thinking I was kidding at first.
Nope.
I convinced her after she looked out the window and saw the black truck begin to speed down the road. My mom wanted me to show her the AIM conversation, but I couldn't, because I had deleted him off my buddy list and blocked him. My parents called the police, of course. That was just for peace of mind. They couldn't do anything besides make a report. The next day, my mom called the Chuck E. Cheese and asked about it then. They said they had no Ben to work there. There were also no employees matching that guy's description. Chuck E. Cheese eventually handed the CCTV footage from the day before to the police department for an investigation. It turned up no results. My family never went to a Chuck E. Cheese ever again.
Nope.